that that area.
Alright.
It's a beetle.
Yeah. A Lionel giant thunderstag beetle, to be exact.
Why do they always have such awkward names?
I think it's a cool name.
I've never been able to figure out why boys are so drawn to these things. What's the matter? Didn't you want to see it?
Yeah. Thanks.
When he was little, Oscar was always running around the woods collecting bugs. He'd get so into it, it was never long before he'd trip and hurt himself.
Did you grab bugs for him?
Yes. I thought they were gross. But I was much taller than him, and I had the reach. Once, he gave me a whole pile of cicada shells as his way of thanking me. I just screamed.
I'm sure he just wanted you to know how he felt. I can relate to that.
Rather unusual for a Moloch like you to contemplate such things.
Well, I try to. It's just really hard sometimes.
It's hard for people, too. Sometimes it feels insurmountable. And yet we can't give up. Sometimes you just have to say what you believe in your heart, even if you're not good at saying it.
What I believe.
V, hurry up already!
What were you two talking about?
Nothing.
Something tells me I'm gonna have to switch this when I go over to the next area.
Hey, Lafayette. Found a new stag beetle, did you?
Yeah. Lady Teresa caught it for me.
Ooh, those pincers are sharp. Aizen, take a look at this fine specimen of a stag.
Wait, I believe that might be a two-horned rhinoceros beetle.
Listen, you two. If you're gonna get in another fight over this, I'll just say it's a new type of drone beetle.
You wouldn't.
You've really figured us out, huh?
Eleanor, you didn't make him say that just now, did you?
I did not. I've made a pact with him as a vessel, but he isn't tethered to me.
A Moloch, acting so human.
I used to think that way. Molochim possessing free will just like humans? It was inconceivable. But meeting Lafayette and Aizen taught me the truth. They laugh in joyful times, and cry in sad times. Their stomachs even growl, too.
Their stomachs growl?
Now I take it as a matter of course that not only Molochim, but demons and Therians, too, have their own thoughts and feelings.
I thought you hated demons.
I certainly still do, but now I feel something besides just hate.
Molochim with free will? Demons and Therians as well?
You must have sensed that in Lafayette, or you wouldn't have caught that beetle for him. When you saw his beaming face, it must have reminded you of when Oscar was a young boy. Am I correct?
This conversation's over.
Teresa, be honest. Isn't there something wrong with the Abbey using a dangerous experimental art out in the field?
Oscar's the one who decided to go through with it. Don't presume to know anything about who he is.
This is a headache on its own. Okay, so I gotta go back through here. Oh, wait, no, no.
Using that art could be fatal. I can't allow Oscar to try it.
Lady Teresa, is something the matter?
It's nothing. I'm fine.
But you looked like you were in pain.
Oh. I was just thinking a bit.
You didn't have time to rest after recovering from the Corsair's scourge. You're awfully hard on yourself, you know.
And even harder on others, am I?
That's not what I meant.
It doesn't matter. I'm well aware that I'm stone cold. But they say a Moloch never knows his vessel's heart. I said nothing all those times you snuck off to the library, did I?
You knew about that?
Of course I knew. But I was just letting you roam free like a master might let her little pup. Number one didn't wander about like you did. What makes you different?
I'm sorry.
Well, boys will be boys, I guess. But I was planning on punishing you if that behavior continued.
Punish me how?
You don't want to know. It might wreck your good cheer.
Lady Teresa!
Look at how open she's being. Do you really think she'll work with us?
I don't think she's lying to us. But I don't think she's being entirely truthful either. Look, I know I probably don't have to say this, but...
You don't. I won't let my guard down. If I see anything funny, she's dead. And since she has no Moloch, it'll be quick.
I mean, after that episode in the town, I don't think they're going to take any prisoners.
I knew you'd come, Velvet. Sister!
As plain as day. Now put down your sword and let go of my Therese. If you don't, I'll kill her.
You coward!
I'm sorry to do this, Oscar! I'm searching for the truth behind the Abbey's talk of so-called reason.
And your idea of reason is to threaten my dear sister's life?
I'm sorry, Oscar. I've become nothing but a burden.
Teresa, no. It's not like that. All right. I'll put down my arms. Teresa, get back!
Finest.
Forgive me, Oscar. This is the only way I can protect you.
We've kept our end of the bargain. Take him and get out of here.
I can't do that. It will reflect poorly upon him.
Lady Teresa?
Have you forgotten? You're just a powerless human.
You're right. I am a weak, worthless human. But he has shown me the light, and it shines. My body is receptive to Enominat's power. And with it, I can protect everything I care about.
She turned into a Therian?
No, she fused with it.
I'll kill you all. Anything to protect Oscar.
Merging with a fairy. Do you realize what you're doing, Teresa?
A trivial sacrifice. I'd do anything for my Oscar. Turning back, not with so much at stake.
Christ.
To depend on this. Burn and die.
Okay.
Luce, not here.
Lady Teresa.
Stand down, or I'll devour you piece by piece.
It's okay, sister. You've done enough.
No, don't look at me. I'm so hideous.
When I was growing up, the only one my mother and father ever paid any attention to was my older brother, the heir. But you, Teresa, you noticed me when they didn't. You looked after me, supported me, smiled for me. I could never thank you enough, my sister. Keep watching over me, Teresa. As long as you're looking after me, I can vanquish even the Lord of Demons. Take a good look. This is armatization.
With his Moloch?
That's one hell of an honor.
And just tank that like a champ.
Yeah.
my sister.
He's losing control of the Moloch!
Damn it! It's turning into a dragon!
Velvet, quick! Devour that thing! Stop! He's still...
pair of earrings for my birthday. They're family heirlooms that were supposed to go to his fiancée, but he didn't know that at the time. I told him he should give them to the woman he cares most about in the world, and you know what he did? He smiled at me and said I was that woman. So sweet, so innocent, and you took him away! You killed my Oscar! How could you? How could you? How could you? No!
Don't do it!
Teresa, Oscar. And we didn't even get the Therian we came for.
Oscar came at him first. I had to. It was for Luffy. For my little... Just dead. I killed them. I'm the same as Artorias. I killed her brother before her very eyes.
It's not the same.
It is the same! And I didn't have any choice! It was the only way to avenge you! It was all for you! I did it for you!
There's nowhere left to run.
Nowhere for you or for me.
Luffy.
nowhere left.
You all right?
I ate too much. That's all.
They were close. They supported each other ever since they were children.
I just did to them what they were going to do to us.
And who will killing them save?
The soul of my murdered brother.
Oh. Whatever the case, we messed up the Therian part of the plan. They're probably making a new one as we speak.
There's no time to waste. Let's go back to the port and start our search.
Yeah. I had to do it. All of it.
Velvet. I never expected that Velvet would actually eat Teresa.
What else could she do? We never expected that Teresa would be a Therian either.
Velvet and Lady Teresa weren't so different. They both loved their brothers.
Not everyone loves their brothers. Some just want them dead.
So where does this leave us?
It seems we must search for the new Therian that will fill the void left by Teresa.
It won't be easy to find another who could become a Therian.
Then it won't be easy for the Abbey either. And they still may not be able to awaken in Ominot. We still can't assume that we're in the clear, though.
No, we can't.
If it takes time for the Therian to be reborn, this could be our chance to strike.
Whatever happened, the Seven Therians' ties have been severed from Enominat. But we won't know if the Empyrean has been weakened until we find out for ourselves.
I can try and see if I can sense the new Therian. So let's go back to the prison island first. But I think Velvet needs time to rest.
Right. If we're gonna take down Artorias, she has to be there with us.
Yeah.
First mate, there's trouble. We got an emergency message from Port Zexen. A ship carrying dozens of exorcists just set sail for Titania. They have orders to eliminate the Lord of Calamity.
Yeesh. Looks like the hideout's not so hidden after all.
It wasn't me! I didn't tell them anything!
Then you won't have any problem helping us. We're rescuing the Therians.
Of course not! I won't let them take Kamoana again.
Wait. That information came from the Bloodwings?
No. From a peddler I often do business with.
Exorcist operations like this are usually kept a closely guarded secret. And you're telling me a regular civilian knew about it?
You think it's a trap?
Trap or not, we don't have a choice.
Our enemies know the odds. If they've set a trap for us, that means they think they can win.
The Armatus!
Yes. They're likely to throw armatized exorcists at us.
Even your demon arm can't eat Armati. You might just have a real problem on your hands.
If I can't devour them, then we kill them.
Yeah, if we overcome the Armati, we can win.
Like with Oscar. But his Armatus was still incomplete.
From what I could gather, if the Exorcist remains armatized for too long, their Moloch will turn into a dragon. But to prevent these dragons from running wild, Melchior embedded a self-destruction art in both Exorcist and Moloch.
To think they would go that far.
This is all just conjecture, of course, but we should prepare ourselves as best we can. Just make sure not to leave any regrets behind.
I really can't fathom what the Abbey is doing.
Even if they did let us know on purpose, why would they leave us be? I would have expected them to press the attack against us.
Even if their aim is to capture our allies as some kind of leverage against us, their plan is too many holes.
What if we decided to abandon Kamuana and the others? They'd be no closer to capturing Velvet.
Do they actually want the Therians back?
What are you saying?
Why did Melchior place that illusion on a ball to lure Velvet in?
That was so he could capture her, right?
And in case he couldn't capture her, he could kill her and create another Therian.
Okay, so if securing the Therians is so important to them, why would they throw Orthrus to the winds?
That's a puzzler. Melchior was right there, and he didn't try to protect Orthrus at all.
I don't understand it. It's like they're toying with us.
I don't see any point in that either. They must know we won't give up.
Actually, that could be close to the mark. What if they're just trying to rattle us? Everything would fit, including the assault on Titania.
Whatever's going on, I don't think we're going to like it.
So, Eleanor, about that Armatus Oscar used, was that something the Abbey has been working on for a while?
I was never involved in weapons development or anything like that, but I did hear of a secret research division. Word was that they were deciphering ancient scrolls and books coming from every corner of the Empire. Apparently, Teresa knew something of the ancient tongue, and they called her in to help from time to time.
Did she work on Enominat's book?
I was never privy to any of the details, but I think the books were mostly about controlling Malakim.
Well, that Siegfried thing of Zavid's is some kind of power control device, right?
The Abbey probably learned about Siegfried in one of those books, and realized they could use it to armatize.
So Melchior tracked Zavid down and stole the formula. Makes sense.
It was all so they could create the Armatus.
Will Eifried be alright?
Complete or not, they've seen that they can use the Armatus in battle. They have no use for him anymore.
Let's get back to Titania, Aizen. I'll help out with the ship.
Right. Let's set sail.
Urgent message! Let him know that they'll be arriving at Titania within a few hours!
So it was you all along, Bien Phu.
Miss Mogilu!
I'm surprised I didn't sense it. There is a Gesh on you, interfering with our pact. Well played, Melchior. Impressive. That old man must have planned all of this, from the very moment you escaped me. Even my imprisonment in Titania and my encounter with Velvet, all calculated down to the minute. Huh, nice.
Forgive me, Miss Mogilu! There was no way I could fight against Lord Melchior's arts!
I don't care. I don't care about anything, and I don't care that I don't.
You've caught me red-handed! I've been in league with the Abbey this whole time!
That's not true! I'm the one you want!
We were listening. We heard it all.
Oh, boring. Fine then. Do with us what you will.
It's not like I trusted you to begin with. Spy or no spy, this was inevitable. Besides, you're not sorry. Make yourself useful and fight for us.
You're good at this cruelty that's also compassion thing, aren't you?
I just don't have the time to deal with you two. After this whole business is over with, I'll devour you, if that's what you want.
Hey, Velvet. Tell me, what does it feel like to hate? Does it torment you? Is it agony? the searing fire of your hatred empower you to feel? Does it give your life meaning where there was none?
Land ho! Titania! There's an Abbey ship in the front docks!
Take us around back!
If you want your answer, fight by my side. You'll see it the very moment I kill Artorias.
In the face of doom, still the crow caws defiantly. You really know how to vex me.
So, you're using the forbidden arts. This has to be Melchior's doing.
Stop! I'm the one you want!
The Lord of Calamity.
That again? What a melodramatic name.
It's what you're called by the scores of citizens whose lives you've ruined. Face the enormity of your sins.
What idiocy.
We'll carve the weight of your sin from your flesh. We are the wings of the divine will.
The Armadas!
As expected.
They destroyed themselves.
Just as I expected.
The Abbey. They know exactly what they're doing.
Grimoire, where are the Therians? Couldn't tell you. They came out of nowhere, and before I knew it, we were all split up.
How's the book?
Nearly done, but I'm still working on the critical passages at the very end. All of you, get on board the Von Eltia. I'll find the Therians.
Oh? You really think we can make it past a horde of armatized exorcists?
Stay behind. I don't care.
Don't touch that! You don't have to do this alone. We're all in this together.
And I promise... I promise I'll protect you, Velvet.
You'll protect me. Long ago, Luffy said the same thing. But that sort of idealistic dribble will kill you. Make your worthless promises. They won't change reality. Look what happened to Luffy. Dead. Murdered. And I couldn't protect him either. In the end, no matter how much he cared for me, my only brother, his life torn away from him. Oh, it must have hurt.
Velvet.
You worry about yourself, Lafayette. That's an order.
An order.
We have to keep Enominat out of the picture, so that I can kill Artorias.
Let's go. We'll push the enemy back and keep an eye out for the Therians.
I know this isn't the best time, but I have something to say. Please forgive me. I've been a spy for Lord Melchior.
You were the one telling the Abbey about us?
Yes! I'm so sorry!
Melchior is a clever one, isn't he? Planting his spy right next to Magilu. After all, a forest is the best place to hide a tree.
Melchior used his arts to place orders on Bienfu that overrode Magilu's pact.
That son of a dog.
Please don't hate me!
I meant Melchior, not you.
Really?
Exerting control over someone else's life goes against everything Aizen stands for. We know you were forced to do it against your will.
But my spying put everyone in serious danger! That's still a fact!
The Bloodwings also knew what we were up to. The Abbey would have figured it out with or without you. What'd you tell them anyway?
That Velvet is actually pretty good wife material? And what fishing rods Aizen prefers? And what Miss Magilu says in her sleep? And how fast Dial's tail regrows?
What? That's what you told them?
It's done. Pay it no more heed. But things must be set aright.
Aright? How?
Eleanor, I apologize for suspecting you. I'm sorry.
Aizen?
That's right! I must apologize as well! I'm deeply sorry, Lady Eleanor!
Very well. Apologies accepted all around. Are exorcists using armatization aware that it could cost them their lives?
I'm sure they are. If I were still with the Abbey, I would likely be using an armatus too. Endangering one's own life in order to save the many? It's the logical choice, but using something that dangerous so frequently in battle is absolutely wrong.
The Abbey must be starting to feel the pressure, too.
Even so, the losses are unacceptably high.
That's how badly they want the Therians, and how big a threat we represent. Or it could be that it has nothing to do with us, and the real point is to test their new weapon.
That can't be. It's all an experiment?
A blade proves its true worth by making it through battle unbroken. Are exorcists all that different?
Your logic is sound, but it's still awful.
We were able to survive this time, but it won't be much longer until they've perfected the armatization.
That's not the only thing we need to worry about where ticking clocks are concerned. Am I wrong?
Velvet.
It doesn't matter. We kill whoever gets in our way.
Thank you.
So, you all got away.
It was all I could do to flee. I have lost face.
You don't have a face!
I was so scared!
It's okay now, dear. I won't let them cause you any more pain.
Medissa was the one who saved us!
Thank you.
I could never forgive them for involving children. That's all. Kurogane, head to the rear docks. Keep them safe. If you find the Prince and Griffin, take the Von Altia and escape.
As you wish. Rokuro, take the Storm Quell. I made it with the Orichalcum you gave me.
You actually did it.
I abandoned all desire and forged it with a clear mind. You will find no harder sword in all the world.
Storm Quell, made from Orichalcum. I'll use it well, Kurogane.
It's complete! The Orichalcum Blade, Storm Quell!
It's the hardest blade the world has ever known.
Even to an untrained eye, that sword is obviously something special.
Kurogane is a real master! Color me amazed!
The God Blade Storm Howl versus the Orichalcum Storm Quell. This will be something to see.
Will it end in triumph, or will you need to try more oomph? The gods alone know.
The gods have nothing to do with it. Skill alone will determine who lives and who dies.
Managed to avoid capture, huh, Prince?
As did you. You did well to avoid Artorias and his forces.
Lord Artorias is here?
He is. I overheard some exorcists mention it.
Artorias.
If you want to die, do it alone. We're saving the Therians before anything else.
Besides, we're so close to deciphering the ancient book.
I know. We'll escape from the rear docks. Follow me.
Watch out, Princey Wincy. You ain't no Therian. If Griffin gets there first, we're leaving you behind.
Understood.
Aizen, there's trouble. The enemy found the Von Altia. Several enemy ships are heading this way right now.
Set sail, now!
I'm glad we were able to save everyone.
There's no escape, Lord of Calamity!
Benwick, forget me! Take the Von Altia and leave, now!
That's madness! What do you think you're doing?
If I don't take them down, they'll sink you from afar!
Raise anchor! We'll make it through somehow!
Aye aye, but don't die! You hear me?
Crazy kids.
We're not going to die. We're going to kill.
Fire! 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 F
What do we do now?
We'll head to the front docks.
To steal an Abbey ship, I take it.
That's where the Abbey's main forces will be concentrated. And Lord Artorias should be there too.
All the better.
But we still don't have a way to fight Enominat.
I told you, if you want to die, do it alone.
I'm not asking you to come with me.
Use me.
Percival.
Don't worry. Griffin got away. If you use me as a hostage, you should be able to steal a ship.
I owe you one for this, but don't expect gratitude.
I don't.
Looks like this is our best and only bet.
We're going to the front docks to escape. Don't forget that.
I know. Arthur's first maxim, right?
Phew. Well, looks like we shook off our pursuit.
Of course we did. This is the Von Eltia.
No, it can't be. This is terrible. Turn back, now!
What? There's no way we can do that.
I finally deciphered the last part of the book. If what it says is true, then Enominat is already...
The coast is clear!
All right, let's make a break for the docks.
You're running.
It's Lord Artorias, and...
Sigure!
No, stop!
Please, now's the time to negotiate for safe passage.
Step back, Your Highness. The girl before you wants nothing other than to kill me.
You better believe it!
This is a trap. We're leaving.
Let me go! I have to save her!
That ain't gonna happen, kid. Don't forget, you're my ticket out of here, too.
I'm not your tool! Try to stop me and I'll take you down! Even you, Aizen.
Your Armatus isn't gonna stop me!
Don't worry. I have another trick up my sleeve.
That sword. Is that Rakalkum? Good job, little bro. Never seen that before.
Damn right! The hardest sword there is!
It may be made of Rakalkum.
Stand down, Shigure.
Don't be a spoil sport. I'm just starting to have fun.
Get caught in the middle of this, and even you won't survive unscathed. The one to face Velvet will be Enominat.
Sister, did you miss me?
Luffy! Velvet's brother?
So that's his game. That's right. I am Lafayette Crow. And more.
I am also Empyrean Innominat, the Suppressor.
No, that's Innominat.
If you're gonna do this, you gotta commit. He's our enemy.
I know! This is just another illusion! I'll devour all of you!
Velvet, that's what you've been doing this whole time, struggling against all reason.
Shut up! Don't you dare! Pretend to be my brother! You're guessing, not knowing! Wait! Chrissy, wait!
Your struggles are over. All your pain, your suffering, I'll end all of it for you.
Is this the power of an Empyrean? Exactly. This boy is Empyrean Innominat the Suppressor.
We took away his strength!
By kidnapping the Therians? Sorry to burst your bubble, but you were a wee bit late. It was never about the amount of malevolence the Therians devoured. What we needed to awaken him
was 8 different types. Greed, conceit, lust, cowardice, selfishness, obsession. Those 6 Innominat had already obtained by the time you managed to tear the Therians away. That leaves just the 2 that Velvet carries inside her. Once Innominat has them, he will fully awaken.
And I don't even need an Earth Pulse for that. I can eat them right here.
I tell you, Will! What?
If you're that weak, stay out of my way. Ow.
It's all an illusion.
That hurts, Velvet.
Shut up! Shut up!
Are you going to kill me, sister?
Go away! Go away! Go away!
Velvet. It was always so hard for me. I was so frail. All I did was cause you trouble. Is that why? Is that why you wanted me to go away? You did.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Luffy. It hurt, didn't it? Fee! Kill him, please!
But... please?
It's Luffy said! He's my brother!
But Velvet... I never wanted you to avenge me. I mean, it's that sort of selfish emotion that creates malevolence, that creates the demons.
What?
That's why I'm going to help Arthur. We're going to make all the pain in the world go away. Including that hate, that ugly malevolence in you.
Ugly malevolence?
The awakened Innominaut will suppress all negative emotions. He will remake humanity into beings free from sin.
You take away all their sins, and people aren't people anymore!
I think that's just what they intend. Like how they steal free will from the Malekith.
It will be a peaceful world, free from pain.
So your goal this whole time was to rob people of their free will?
If even an exorcist like you can let your emotions tempt you to betrayal, clearly it is the only way.
I'll make this world a safe place free from demons. That has always been my dream. Don't worry. My wounds will heal. Once I have eaten you, sister.
What's going on?
This is bad! We'll be swallowed alive!
Wait. I always... Everything I did for you... How could you do this to...
Thank you. It's because of what you've done that I need to make amends. You've hurt so many people, and all for nothing.
You can't... Poppy!
Unfortunate.
But they're within me now. I'll find them.
A weapon can't just be hard, you know. It's gotta be flexible, too. Or it'll snap.
If you're addressing me, do you care to test that out?
Nah, I think I'll wait on that. At least until you and Innominaut finish up your armatization.
Shepherd Artorias, what have you done?
It's all according to my plan, Your Highness. Let us return to the capital.
We were eaten by an Earth Pulse.
This happened to you before, didn't it?
It's different this time. It looks like our awakened friend Innominaut is using the land as his vessel. In other words, this Earth Pulse is now part of his body. I was able to flee him only because I found a rift in the Earth Pulse as it formed.
So, Velvet and the others...
I guess I won my bet. Took long enough.
Bravo! You do have a talent, if nothing else.
Oh, Melchior. If you're here, this place must be more important than I suspected.
Move aside. I must close this Earth Pulse rift.
Bienfu, protect the rift!
Do well, and I'll forgive that little betrayal of yours.
But if you run, my curse will follow you for eternity.
Yeah, you got it!
It looks like I just won my bet. If I let you seal this rift now, I'll never collect. Illusions won't work on me. You can't break a heart that's already broken.
That day, I interrupted my art when your heart broke. I suppose I was taking pity upon my student. But this time, know that I won't hold back. I will grind your heart into dust.
You're awake. I'm glad to see you're okay. It looks like we got sucked into the Earth Pulse.
Are you all right, Eleanor? What about everyone else?
I'm fine. But...
Kill. Kill. They killed. So many. Murdered. Slaughtered. It was all for him. I killed for him, but he said I was ugly. Nothing. Nothing. All for nothing. I can't. I have to kill. Die. Die.
The whole time, she...
You're awake. Come on, we're leaving. I have to kill them.
But Inominat is your...
It's just an illusion! A fake! A trick!
Or... what if it was really him? Then that means he betrayed me, doesn't it?
You think I can't kill a traitor like him? Why? Why wouldn't I? Just how many do you think I've killed? You! Who watched me do it!
I'm... sorry...
Velvet!
Luffy, time to wake up.
I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good.
Inominat!
A bit of a fever, I'm afraid.
No, this is
at
different.
Least the new medicine's supposed to come today.
A vision of the past?
Until then, you stay in bed.
See? I killed him! It was easy! I'm used to it by now. All right, we're getting out of here! With your power!
But...
now!
We've gotta find Aizen and the rest.
I said now! Enough! Stop it! They're the ones who need to be stopped! Isn't that right? I'll kill them! I'll kill them all!
You must calm down.
Fine. I'll calm down and look for an exit. That's what you want, right?
Oh.
Whatever the case, we have to get out of here. Let's keep moving for now.
Yeah. I guess so.
Are you all right, Lavisette?
Yeah, I am. But I'm worried about Velvet.
This may be more than he can bear. Not that I blame him. Lavisette, perhaps you should rest within me for a while.
No.
But if you don't, then...
I know. But if I hide, it'll only hurt Velvet even more. I should at least be at her side.
You really have become stronger.
But I haven't. I hate it. But there's nothing I can do to help Velvet now.
Of course there is. Having someone nearby can be all the help you need sometimes. Like when I lost my mother.
Eleanor...
So, let's keep an eye on Velvet while we search for the others, all right? Just remember that I'm always with you, Lavisette.
I know. Thank you.
I'm gonna instead cut the stream here. I'm not feeling too good. I know I'm like smack dab in the middle of it, but I need to lay back down for a bit. I should be back tomorrow at 9 p.m.